lights once again here in Qatar. Last year, we took a year off due to a small footballing tournament that was being hosted, but it's all excitement on the track now. We're back here in Lusail for a track that's 3.34 miles long. There are 16 turns around its unique three-pronged shape and just a single DRS zone out of turn 16. It's fast and it's flowing, and there's a good overtaking opportunity with DRS down the long straight and into turn one. Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. Hansen lines up on pole position, and Lewis Hamilton completes the front row. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Oscar Piastri, Verstappen, Norris, Joe, Reed, Leclerc, Perez, Albon, Gasly, Hülkenberg, Ocon, Russell, Sainz, Sargeant, Tsunoda, Bottas, De Vries, and Kevin Magnussen fills the last spot on the grid. It's almost time for those five red lights to go out then. Let's see who can prevail today. With the Grand Prix nearly upon us, Anthony Davidson is by my side once again to offer his perspective.
Seeing any technical issues coming off the practice start. Watch the RPM on the full start. We don't want you to bog down. Rainfall expected today. We think it'll stay dry. okay. To manage this, we're going to need to lower our ERS deployment mode. Got a lot of spare energy, okay to use your overtake button. Try to stay with them. We might make a mistake, but we can still regain the position. DRS is being enabled this lap. You can use DRS when you're within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. Seconds. okay. No issues with tyre wear for now. Keep taking care of them. Okay, mate, don't worry about the damage. I've got some new strategy options if you go and check your MFD. That was a fantastic stop, faster than we were expecting. Okay, stay clear of the white line on the exit. We'll receive a penalty for dangerous driving if you cross onto the track. Okay, keep an eye on that gap ahead, please. 12.1 seconds. overtake now. Come on, push hard. Just a reminder, we're critical on fuel, probably a lap or so short. We don't need to risk a DNF chasing records, so let's think about starting to conserve fuel, maybe lifting early into the corners. Okay, here's the gap that we're trailing the car ahead by, 4.4 seconds. Okay, so we're leading our teammate by 10.7 seconds. yellow flag. Green flag. Okay, be careful. We think you're going to start losing some tyre grip any time now. Starting to catch the car in front, but we need to look after the tyres. Won't be making another pit stop. Dropping a second a lap to the car behind. 1 second. Just 5 laps of fuel remaining. Turbocharger's on its last legs. Let's try to keep mileage on it to a minimum. Okay, clear. you've got enough fuel for three more laps. Okay, we've only got one lap of fuel remaining. We'll be right back.
And under the desert night sky, they win the Qatar Grand Prix. And what a performance it was. Tell me, Ant, how do you think they were able to deliver such an incredible result today?
Well, they certainly stood out as a driver with tons of confidence on the track. I think their ability to keep their cool, even during some of the more hectic parts of the race, meant they were able to capitalise on the mistakes of other drivers, giving them the opportunity to make their way to the top spot with ease.
I can see them on their way out to the podium now. Aston Martin are really making waves in this sport. And what a special race this was to see them earn that top spot.